Okay, so now we're gonna focus on another group of functions under the category raw level calculations, the null functions. The main purpose of the null functions in Tableau is to handle and manipulate the missing values in our data, the nulls. We can have missing values like everywhere in text, dates, numbers, any field in our data source can have like missing values. So why handling the missing values, handling the nulls is a very important step in the analysis, and that's because of two things. First, the calculation accuracy. Null values can affect the calculations and the aggregations in the results. So if we have null values in our data and we ignore it, we don't do anything about it, what's gonna happen? We're gonna have incorrect calculations and corrupt results. The second reason is to improve the data quality and to achieve completeness. Identifying the data gap, the wrong in the data entry, and having issues in the data collection can help the overall data quality in our data and can improve as well the completeness in the data visualizations. So that's why the null functions in Tableau are very important to have accurate and correct analysis in the data visualizations. So as usual, let's understand the concept, then we can practice. Let's go. Okay, so now let's go and understand those three functions, zn, fnull, isnull, in order to handle our missing values. As usual, we're gonna go with the example because it is the best way to understand those functions. Alright, so now we're gonna have four customers and their sales. As you can see, only Maria has a missing value in the sales, so we have here a null. In order to handle this null, we have the first function in Tableau, the zn. Zn stands for zero nulls. It can replace the null values with zero, so it's very simple. If you use now the zn function for the sales, for the first value we will not change anything, right? We will get exactly the same value, but for the next one, since it's a null, it's gonna replace it automatically with a zero. The next two customers we will get exact values because they are not nulls. So as you can see, very simple, we are just replacing the null values with a zero. So this is a very quick way to replace the nulls. But here the problem is we have no control what we are replacing. So here we cannot specify something else. We will always get a zero. In order now to specify our value, we can use the second function that we have in Tableau, ifNull. ifNull is going to replace the null value with a specific value from us. So if you use this function on the sales, it can has the following syntax. It needs two arguments: the value that we want to manipulate and the value that we specify. So in this example, I'm going to specify it as zero. It doesn't make sense because we can use zn, but just to show you that, we're going to get the same results. So you can go over here and put anything you want. So for the first customer, we're going to get exactly the same results. For the second customer, we're going to get again a zero because we specify that, we have the control on that. And then for the last two customers, we're going to get exact results. And here the output is a number because the field that we want to manipulate is a number. But let's say that we take another field which is a string, the output gonna be as well a string. So here is exactly the difference between zn and ifNull. Zn accepts only numbers, but the ifNull accepts any field from your data source. So for example, let's say that we have the countries. So John has no value in the country. Same for Martin. We have only for Maria and George informations inside the field country. Here we cannot go and use the zn function because it's not number, it's string. So in order to manipulate those values or to replace the null values, we're gonna go and use the ifNull. So the syntax is gonna look like this. If null country, then we have the abbreviation of not applicable. So the output here gonna be a string value. For the first customers, we're gonna replace the null with an A. The next one is gonna stay the same because there is nothing to replace. The third one we're gonna get as well, not applicable. And for the last one, we will get France. So nothing to be changed. So this is exactly the differences between the ifNull function and the zn function in Tableau. Now we're gonna go to the last function, isNull. Sometimes we might be in a situation where we want to check whether the field has null values or not. So we don't want to do any actions yet. We are just checking, right? So the isNull in Tableau gonna return true if the value is null and false otherwise. So that means if there is no value, if we have missing value, we're gonna get true. If there is a value, we will get false. So the output of this function gonna be with the data type boolean with only two values, either true or false. So let's check the example or the syntax in Tableau. It's gonna accept only one argument, the country, and that's it. So the question for the first customer, is it a null? Yes, it's null, so that's why we're gonna get true. For the next customer, is it null in the country? Well, no, so we're gonna get false. The same for the third one, we're gonna get true. And the last one, we're gonna get false because we have a value in the country. So that's it for the is null. So we have three functions, three tools to manipulate or to check the null values inside our fields. And they are really useful to improve the quality and the completeness of your visualizations. So now let's go back to Tableau and start practicing them. Okay, so this time we're gonna go to the small data source. Let's check the orders information. So we're gonna take the order ID and we're gonna take this time the profit. So drag and drop the profits on the ABC over here to see the values. And now if you check our data, you can see that the order 7 don't have any profit informations, and as well the order 10 don't have anything. So we have here missing data, we have nulls. So now let's do something about it and fix it. Instead of having null, we have to have zeros. So here we have two functions to do it. Let's start with the first one, the ZN zero nulls. So now we're gonna fix it and create a new calculated field. We're gonna call it profit ZN, and the syntax starts with the function ZN, and it needs only one argument, the field that we need to fix. So it's gonna be the profits. So that's it. With that, we are changing all the null values to zero. So again, in this function, we don't have control to change the value to something else. It's going to be always zero. So the calculation is valid. Everything is nice. Let's click OK. And as usual, we're going to get new measures, since the output is going to be as well with the profit informations. So drag and drop this new information to the view. And now we can see on the results, all those values are going to stay the same. Only we are manipulating the nulls. So we are replacing the nulls with a zero. Here as well, for the order number 10, we have null. Now we have a zero. So it's really easy and quick fix. All right, so now you might say, you know what, why we are making all those efforts to replace those missing values with zero? So what is the big deal? I could just leave it as a null and the users might accept it. So why we are doing this? Well, it's not only the visual gonna be better, but also having missing values gonna bring wrong and inaccurate aggregations. So let me show you what I mean. Let's just remove the order ID away. And now you can say, okay, we got the same numbers, right? We got the same aggregation, so everything is accurate and fine. Well, not exactly. This is only for the sum. So now let's go and switch them both to the average. So we're gonna go over here and switch it to average. And we're gonna do the same for the corrected one. So now I'm gonna just make the headers a little bit wider to see the values. So now as you can see, now we are getting different values. So with the ZN function, we got different average from the original data. And that's because in this average, we are not counting the orders with the missing values. With the ZN, we are counting now the orders with the missing values. So that means replacing the missing values with zeros, we will get accurate results at the average in the aggregations compared to the old one. So that's exactly why we go and replace the missing values with zeros, especially for aggregations and calculations. All right, so that's why we do it. Now let's go and try another function. We're gonna use the if null in order to replace the null values with zeros. And now I'm gonna just bring the order ID to the view to see all the orders. Let's go and create the new calculated field. And we're gonna call it profit if null. And the syntax starts with if null. And it needs two informations. The first one gonna be the field that we want to manipulate. So it's gonna be the profit again. And for the next information, we have to specify which value gonna replace the null. So in this example, we're gonna stay with the zero. So the calculation is valid. Let's hit OK. And we got again our new calculated field. Let's bring it to the view and check the results. As you can see, it is identical to the ZN. So for the order number 7, instead of null, we got zero. The same for the 10, we got as well zero. So in this situation, if we want to replace it with zeros, I would go with the ZN since it's just faster to write it. So now let's move to the next scenario where we want to replace the nulls with the value 1. So this time we cannot use the ZN because ZN can automatically convert it to zero. We're gonna stick with the if null. So let's go and edit our calculation. And instead of zero here, we're gonna specify 1. So let's go and hit OK. And now we can see instead of having zero, we have the value 1. So instead of null, we have 1. So this is the advantage of the if null. We can control which value gonna be the replacement for the null. All right, the next advantage of the if null is that we can replace not only number values, we can replace as well any other data type. So let's take an example. We're gonna go to the customers and let's get the customer email to the view. And as you can see here, we have some nulls. We don't have all the emails from all customers, but now the task is to replace those nulls with unknown. So let's go and create a new calculated field in order to replace those values. Let's call it customer email if null. And the syntax again, if null, It accepts two arguments, the field that you want to manipulate, it's going to be the customer email, so this one over here, and which value we're going to use in order to replace the nulls, it's going to be the unknown. So that's it, the calculation is valid, so we're going to replace all the nulls with this value. So let's go and hit OK. And now we have again here a new dimension in our data source. Let's grab it to the view and check the values. So now if you just compare those two columns, you can see instead of null, we are getting unknown, the same here and the third one over here. And the others will not be affected because we have a value inside the field. So as you can see, it's really nice and quick way to replace those bad nulls in the view. So that's all for the if null. Now let's check the last one we have, the is null. So the isNull will not replace the values with anything, it's just to check whether there is a null or not. So let's say that we want to check whether in the field profit we have any nulls. In order to do that, we're going to go and create again a new calculated field. Let's call it a profit isNull. And the syntax for that is very easy. So is null, and it accepts only one argument. It's going to be the field that we want to check. So we are checking the field of profit. So the calculation is valid, and that's it. It's really simple. We are checking whether this field contains any nulls inside it. So the output can be either true or false. So it's going to be a Boolean. So let's hit OK. And now as you can see on the left side, we have a new field with the data type Boolean because we have only true and false. Let's drag and put it on the view over here. And here we can see quickly all those orders is a false because we have a value inside the profit. But here we have a null. That's why we are getting true. And here again, we have a true. So with that, we can check immediately whether we have nulls inside our data or not. So let's go and show it as a filter. This is what I usually do. So if I see there is true, I'm interested to see those values. So I can see, all right, we have two orders where we have nulls inside the value profit. So this is really quick way in order to check whether we have any problems, any nulls inside our fields in order to make plan what we're going to do about it. But here in the small data source, it's really easy to see in the visual, like all the orders, we have only 10 orders, but imagine you have thousands or millions of orders inside your data. In the visual, it can be really hard to see. So let's take an example in the big data source. So we're going to go over here, take again the order ID. And as well, let's check this time the sales. So drag and drop it in the view. As you can see, it's really hard to check now in the view whether we have nulls or not. So instead of that, we can do a check. So we're going to go and create a new calculated field. Let's call it sales is null. And now we can use the function is null. This time the field going to be sales. So we are checking the sales. So let's go and hit OK. And now we're going to show this field as a filter. So now in the filter, we can see immediately that we have only one value, false. So we don't have true. That means we don't have any nulls inside our data. So this is very quick check inside our data to see whether there are nulls instead of just like scrolling down and checking all the orders. That's why we need the isNull function. So with that, we have covered all the three functions that deal and handles with the null. This is very important to improve the quality of your visualizations and to bring accurate data in the aggregations. All right, so with that, we have covered everything about how to handle the missing value, the nulls in Tableau. Next, we're gonna move to another group of functions, the logical functions. And if you like my content and you want to support the channel, then I really appreciate it if you support, like, and comment. This is really gonna help the YouTube algorithm. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.